사피엔스, 브리프 히스토리 오브 휴먼카인드, 유발노아 하라리, 스켈레톤스 인더 클로젯, 호모 사피엔스 해즈 캡트 히든 언 이븐 모 디스터빙 시크릿. Not only do we possess the abundance of uncivilized cousins, once upon a time, we had quite a few brothers and sisters as well. You are used to think about ourselves as the only human because of the last 10,000 years, our species has indeed been the only human species around. Yet the real meaning of the word human is an animal belonging to a genus, Homo, and there used to be many other species of this genus besides Homo sapiens. Moreover, as we shall see in the last chapter of the book, in the not so distant future, we might again have to contend with non-sapiens humans. To clarify this point, I'll often use the term sapiens to denote members of the species Homo sapiens, while reserving the term human to refer to all extant members of the genus Homo. Humans first evolved in East Africa about 2.5 million years ago from an early genus of apes called Australopithecus, which means southern ape. About 2 million years ago, some of these archaic men and women left their homeland to journey through and settle vast areas of North Africa, Europe, and Asia. Since survival in the snowy forest of northern Europe required different traits than those needed to stay alive in Indonesia's steaming jungle, human population evolved in different directions. The result was several distinct species, to each of which scientists have assigned a pompous Latin name. Humans in Europe and West Asia evolved in Homo neanderthalensis, man from the Neanderthal Valley, popularly referred to simply as Neanderthals. Neanderthals, bulkier and more muscular than as sapiens, were well adapted to the cold climate of Ice Age Western Eurasia. The more western region of the Asia were populated by Homo erectus, upright men who survived there for close to a million years, making it the most durable human species ever. This record is unlikely to be broken even by our own species. It's doubtful whether Homo sapiens will still be around 1,000 years from now. So 2 million years is really out of our league. On the island of Java, in Indonesia, lived Homo solanus, man from the Solo Valley, who was suited to life in the tropics. On another Indonesian island, the small islands of Flores, archaic humans underwent a process of dwarfing. Humans first reached Flores when the sea level was exceptionally low, and the island was easily accessible from the mainland. When the sea rose again, some people were trapped on the island, which was poor in resources. Big people who need a lot of food died first. Smaller fellows survived much better. Over the generation, the people of Flores became dwarfs. This unique species, known by scientists as Homo floresiensis, reached a maximum height only 1 meter and weight no more than 25 kilograms. They were nevertheless able to produce stone tools and even managed occasionally to hunt down some of the island's elephants. Though, the Homo floresiensis. To be fair, the elephants were a dwarf species as well. In 2015, 10, another lost sibling was rescued from oblivion. When scientists excavating the Denisova cave in Siberia discovered a fossil finger bone, genetic analysis proved that the finger belonged to a previously unknown human species, which was named Homo Denisova. Who knows how many lost relatives of ours was waiting to be discovered in other caves, on other islands, and in other climes. While these humans were evolving in Europe and Asia, evolution in Asia Africa did not stop. The cradle of humanity continued to nurture numerous new species, such as Homo rudolfensis, man from Lake Rudolph, Homo ergasters, walking man, and eventually our own species, which we've immodestly named Homo sapiens, wise man. The number of some of these species were massive and others were dwarf. Some were fearsome hunters and others meek plant gatherers. Some live only on a single island while many roam other continents. But all of them belong to the genus Homo. They were all human beings. It's a common fallacy to envision these species as arranged in a straight line of descent, with ergaster begetting erectus, erectus begetting the Neanderthals, and the Neanderthals evolving into us. This linear model gives the mistaken impression that at any particular moment of omni one type of human inhabited the earth, and that all earlier species were merely older models of ourselves. The truth is that from about 2 million years ago until around 10,000 years ago, the world was home at one and the same time to several human species. And why not? Today there are many species of foxes, bears and pigs. The earth of 100 million years ago was walked by at least 6 different species of man. Is our current exclusivity not that multi-species past that is peculiar and perhaps incriminating? As we will certainly see, we sapiens have good reason to depress the memory of our siblings. Okay.